This update is for Steven only. No one else listened.
Sorry, I gotta,
but no, update it to... Okay. I'm okay.
Hello, hello.
I signed my lease with the
Michigan
apartments, which is right across the street. So whenever you're coming to my place, you don't have to do anything. It's literally turning in the same place.
Probably. I'll probably still come here. Come in here.
It's going to tip over, Mark.
More than usual?
That's all I'm trying to say. It's not a good angle for the feet.
No. You push the feet just sticky carpet. It's one of the reasons why I want to go.
There you go.
Just Steven stick.
Oh, dude, don't even look under your couch. It's just, it's as hard as a rock under there. It's just diamonds. little jizz diamonds down there.
What?
Jizz diamonds.
Under his couch. He said he wanted to move because his carpet's so sticky from all the times that I jerk off in his apartment.
That's true.
Oh, yeah.
And I said, don't look under the couch. It's just little jizz diamonds down there.
Stalagmites.
I saw a comedian this weekend and he made a joke about that, saying when you walk around, he jacks off just on the floor. And he said that he, when you walk through his house, your feet will turn to cum paper mache.
Oh, man.
I kind of want to do that in a hotel room now.
Just why not? Floor jizz.
Floor jizz.
You never just came on the floor in a hotel room?
I've always
first thing
been,
I fucking do.
I've always been there with other people.
Oh.
Hey, Dad, don't look.
I guess I could have done it at PAX, but...
Yeah.
There's always time.
In Matt's room.
Hey, Matt, don't look.
I'd be like, that's fine. I'll go out to the balcony, I guess, again.
Jerk off on the balcony again.
I can only spend so much time on the balcony, Mark. I'm getting kind of bored.
Lee Harvey Oswald somebody from the balcony.
Is that what it's called?
Dude, JFK.
The ending scene from Happiness. Did you guys see that one?
No.
Oh, thanks for reading it, though.
He finally came. Well, that's not the point of the ending, but he did finally come.
Oh, that's good.
On the balcony. And then he showed his family and was really excited about it.
Look, I came.
There's a Chuck Palahniuk movie where his like colon's impacted or something because he like shoved something up his ass, and like one of the climaxes at the end is that someone like hugs him like very hard and it like unplugs him and it just shit comes out.
Oh man.
Yeah. Which one is that? That's the one where he's like works at the Anachronistic Society.
Yeah, I forget
like
the name.
Choke.
Is it Choke?
Choke.
Okay, yeah. Choke.
It's like because
he's a con artist. That was a good one.
Bears eating a bunch of rocks so they don't shit during the winter.
Happiness is Todd Solondz. He's fucked up.
There's John Lovitz in it, right?
I think so.
Where he tells that girl she's shit and he's like gold or something like that.
Probably. It's got the dad who's the child molester and he like...
Good movie.
Are you guys and talking about the TV show The Critic?
Yeah.
I love that
at one point,
show.
Buy my book.
The dad's a child molester and the son gets jealous and he says like, Dad, would you molest me? And he said, no, son. I just jerk off and watch. I'm like, oh my fucking God.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Let me evaluate what I'm doing with my life at the moment.
Yeah.
What? Why would someone ask their dad that?
His dad molested other kids, and he was wondering why his dad didn't molest
he felt
him.
Left
pretty
out.
Much like
Mr. Garrison.
Mr. Garrison.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He felt left out.
Yeah.
The fuck?
Yeah.
You loved all those other little boys more than me. Yeah. All the time.
The fuck?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's fucked up.
So, Corey, is your druid going to like eat rocks whenever you're in bear form?
Yeah. Well, I got to eat a bunch of rocks so I don't poop during the winter, and I got to keep it all in. I don't want to do any hibernation poops.
Do those rocks just like jut out of your stomach when you transform back into bear form?
No, they're just in my ass. My ass just.
Well, all
dude,
his HP bulging. Comes back. So.
Ass rocks.
Yeah, ass rocks.
You know when you're out collecting rocks? Probably had one of my ass rocks.
So many kids would touch my ass rocks.
Okay, I think we're think,
trying to skip those
we're good.
Stones.
Chainmail's Bush League.
Are we ready?
Yeah,
ready.
We're ready. We're ready to D&D.
Here we go.
Welcome to the party where we're at one table playing D&D. I'm Dusty.
I'm Corey.
I'm Mark.
I'm Steven.
And I'm Matt.
Yeah! Let's party roll.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Oh, man.
Welcome to copyright infringement roll.
Fair use roll.
Please keep it going. Just keep it going.
It just lightly in the background for the rest of the episode.
The entire episode.
Just watch us get angrier and angrier.
Well, you gotta slowly make it get louder.
Yeah, just slowly until it just blares.
But also, like, also behind it, there's just like the sound of a million shrieking crows.
It's like in my dreams.
What's that all about?
It's like, hold on, Steven. You get advantage. I get advantage. You get advantage.
You get advantage, Jerry.
What do I do for advantage? You roll twice. Not once, but twice. Twice, Jerry.
What do I do?
Two dice.
You give me the dice. I don't know what to do. Okay. Roll.
Oh,
fuck
yeah.
All of you.
Party roll.
10.
Party roll to beat is an 18.
Damn it. I did 7.
What is with this fucking party
17.
Roll?
What are you, it's been a 1 for the last 7 times.
Oh, yeah. We want to be better than you all the time.
16 to party.
Because I didn't
no one
the,
parties.
Did anybody party?
No. I got a 17. I think I had the most. Can I come and look at the party?
Can I just come on the carpet of the party?
Under the couch. Slagmites.
It's like you're walking around on Cheetos.
Last time on Party Roll.
Yeah, what happened?
Your apartment smells like
hold
cotton
on.
Candy.
We took over the ship. We got to the place.
We ate a lot of pineapples.
Yeah.
Oh, we insulted the townspeople and we were going to go find their neighbor.
Well, I kind of insulted them too. I kind of took apart.
It was positive, you know, it was like encouraging them. It was positive criticism to make them better.
I think it's a backhanded compliment is what the word is.
Yeah. So we were going to find their friend who's getting stolen by some sandworms or something.
Sure.
To be fair, though, Fritz picked up a piece of stone. It's not like he was chiseling on their graveyard.
Oh yeah, Fritz stole some of their gravestones.
I picked one up.
He wasn't mad. Being reminded of how far they'd fallen made him kind of sad.
Oh, okay.
That's fine.
I helped with that. Yeah, that's fine.
And I helped to remind him of that too.
So being pathetic made him feel pathetic.
Basically.
But it's all copacetic.
Seeing the monuments that his people used to maintain.
Yeah. Now, and this is a question I'd probably want to ask him in character, but like, did he actually build these, or were like his grandparents?
This was generation or about 2 generations ago.
So he's never done anything worthwhile in his entire life.
He's just moped. He's a moper.
He's just farmed shit crops his whole life.
Shit crops.
Yeah. Why didn't he try to? I don't know.
Kill himself?
Thing. Yeah, that too.
He was too afraid. He tried, and he was a suicidal failure.
Just walk out into the field where everyone's getting like, you know, abducted or whatever. And just let it take you and fucking kill you.
Field of broken
dreams. You guys
dreams.
Walk out to the field but and the entire city is just standing out there waiting.
But they never take him. That's the trick. Yeah. They never take him.
You. No, not you. No, we'll get you next time. We promise.
No, really. We'll get you next time.
Next time.
Which one of you was it that convinced him to give you something?
That was me.
Oh, good job there, Jedwin.
Yeah, well, I mean, we got to get something out of this. This is not the main mission. This is kind of a side thing.
And they need some walking around money.
Yeah, I mean, side gigs. You get some side money.
What was his name again?
Sadman.
I think it's pronounced Sadman.
Jeff Sadman.
Did anybody write his name down? Because I...
Jeff?
No, I didn't write his
pretty
name.
Sure I gave Sadman. Him an, I gave him an... Oh, I think I named him after somebody. I don't know.
Matt.
Oh, I was supposed to have a list.
Sorry, whoever Sadman. I named it after. Well, we decided to calm down on that because we're going to run out of fans. Because we've got about 12. We've used about 9.
And we're going to start naming characters after ourselves.
Like Matt Sadman.
This is Dust Mattman.
We're gonna name the next character Steven's mom.
Just that.
Just not her name.
Not
Steven's
my mom's
mom.
Name. She is the number one fan.
She is our number one fan.
She's Steven's mom.
Number one.
We like to thank all our moms and girlfriends. All right, you guys went out, or you were heading out to the pastures?
Yes.
Outskirts of town.
Taking Steven's mom out to the pasture.
I guess we should address...
Sorry, Steven.
We are missing a player tonight. So, yeah, our Fumbles will be oddly quiet.
Fumbles has diarrhea.
Fumbles is just going to hang back at the town and just let loose.
Take some time off.
Could you don't do that? Here, okay. Well, just
let loose.
I'll go get the
stool loose.
blow off your Sunday shoes.
The town was so repressed. Love it. Love it.
The town is so repressed.
Now it smells like an Arby's.
Gross. Gross.
Just hot meat and cheese
everywhere. I enjoy a fine Arby's every now and then.
Fumbles is just making patty melts all over town.
That's Whataburger? I'm a little offended.
Not on my toast. Oh, okay. Just, on my toast then. Just do it. I wasn't hungry today.
We're going to back up here. You actually eat Arby's?
I enjoy an Arby's.
Dude, Arby's fucking rocks.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I liked Arby's in like middle school.
Sometimes
but
I like putting my mouth.
I would
on
rather
roast
eat
beef.
Day old chicken from Walmart than Arby's.
I actually had my 15th birthday alone with my mom at Arby's, and it was really sad.
Alone?
Would your mom drop you off?
Well, no, we were. No,
she said it at a different table.
Sorry.
Happy
what
birthday, Corey, bye.
It was just
I'll be
me
back
and
an
my
hour.
Mom, we were at Arby's, and it was funny because she was like, well, where do you want to go? And I was like, oh, let's just go to Arby's. And so we went to Arby's, and there was...
Okay, I will say that. You never... Even though I enjoy Arby's, you're never excited about it. It's always kind of resigned.
I was
like really, Long John Silver's.
I was really excited about the curly fries. But the best part of the story is we get
you
there.
Don't go to Long John Silver's.
And one of their machines was broken, so it made this really horrible, like, buzzing noise. Like, just it completely filled the room. Like, you could tell that all the employees were just mad to be there. And my mom is just sitting there, like, trying to make me have a good birthday because no one could come to it.
Happy
and,
birthday,
like, even my
horsey sauce.
Family was busy. And so we're just sitting there and she's like, you having a good time? I'm like, that noise is really loud. And yeah, it's good.
Oh, shit.
That's like the saddest.
Can I go home, masturbate in my room, Mom?
I just want to go home and play some Call of Duty when it was
Medal
of Honor.
Oh, yeah.
That was the first Medal of Honor game I played on PlayStation.
Good. Oh, you liked the first two Call of Duties, too, I really liked.
Yeah, I did. It was amazing. And then they got money.
Hey, man. Call of Duty 4 was great.
It was.
But then it just Call of Duty 4 Part 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 were not as great.
Into the future, yeah.
No, that's fine.
Thank you for joining us on the video game podcast.
And now
we got to talk about movies soon,
Now I'm Corey Sadman. So.
Oh, Corey Sadman.
Do you want to talk about Mad Max? Because that will be the entire podcast if we do that.
Oh, dude, I could talk all day about that.
Actually, let's talk about Mad Men. I just saw the John Deere scene
I'm
with the British men.
Hey,
that shit was brutal,
dude. Ooh, I'm not there.
Okay,
I'll
drop that out there.
Anyway.
I've watched an episode of that show.
Did you like it?
Yeah, it was okay. Matt made me watch it.
You know what I liked?
He held me down and sat in my lap, and then we watched it together.
Yeah.
Giggling and constantly bouncing. not him.
I have not seen a full episode of the show. I am a fan of Christina Hendricks, though.
Of course.
I'm a fan of Jimi Hendricks.
Yeah. No. No. Yeah. Christina wins.
Okay, let's play D&D. Yay!
We were all in character talking about this as we were in the town.
Yeah, you guys
were
talking about all your favorite shows on your way to the shitty
away from
outskirts
this
of shit house
shitty town. We're in.
I think I gave the town a name. It was like Eldridge, I think.
Sure.
I thought it was weird because it sounds like one of my spells.
Well, I just pulled it out of my ass.
The
so.
Spells.
Oh, yeah, you have like
Eldridge Missile.
Eldridge Blast.
Blast.
It's a
missile's blast.
At the
it's
end.
Fine. Right. Same thing.
So you guys get to the outskirts of town. Mm-hmm. There's some, there's lots of dirt. Mm. It's just kind of a dirt path that
I
leads out of town.
Four to kick dirt.
you just kind of do a little aw shucks.
Okay. Mm. I sweep it a little bit.
A bit of dust.
Hey.
Comes up.
I'm going to take a sample of the dirt.
Okay.
Yeah.
Man, this place makes me sad. I'm from a swamp.
What are you collecting this in?
I just want a little vial I have.
Oh,
yeah,
you have a little sample vial.
Yeah.
So
I got,
just keep it in my mouth.
I just push it to the side when I get another
gnomes
another
have
sample.
Little pouches in there they can keep.
Oh,
starting.
Yeah, we do for years.
He keeps his credit card and, like, social security card on one side and then, like, dirt samples
on
the
I
other.
That's why I look jolly all the time because my cheeks are so full of dirt and my car keys and just other things.
It looks to be standard. It's mostly sand and clay. You can tell there's not a lot of loam. Because it's not very good soil.
Okay. I know what loam is.
Yeah.
For our layman, can you explain what that made-up word is?
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, God. Am I doing this now?
No, you're not. Let's keep going.
Okay. Look it up later.
Loam means Rory's carpet cum.
Dude, you're not a loam in not knowing what it means.
Zing.
But
some geologist just cracked up somewhere.
I get that reference.
Shout out to our geologist fans.
Yeah, all of you.
You can tell a little out that there is a pasture. There are some meager, shitty-looking crops out there. That's everything in this
shit
town.
Crap.
Shit crops. Shit crops. As Buria.
So is there just no, like, moisture around? No water?
I mean, we are on an island.
It's just really shitty soil. I mean, it's not... it's not exceptionally dry.
Is
it's
there
just
a volcano on this island?
Have they been growing a lot of corn?
My question's more important.
There's... Who are you asking?
I perception to see if I see a volcano around.
Go for it.
Perceptify.
Curious. A natural one.
Eyes fall out.
Some of that dirt got.
You suspect the entire island may be a volcano.
Whoa. Because I rolled a one?
I just shrugged for everyone listening.
Let's just to ignore that inkling.
All right. I'm just going to be like, I wonder if this is an island. That was to myself. So I'm just like, maybe, probably. Ooh, or the whole thing's a volcano. And I just kept walking.
Intriguing. Oh, wait. I don't have your voice.
No one has my voice.
What was your voice again?
I'm not going to do it right now. You put me on the spot, Mark.
Hey, Corey, can you do the voice?
Yes.
Yeah.
No, fuck you. Anything for Steven. For Salinas.
So.
Did you say for Salinas?
Anything for Salinas.
Perfect.
Salinas.
That's where he got the voice. He took it and he took the
Latino away. Oh, yeah.
Took
I just watched
Latino
that
away.
Like 2 weeks ago.
Watched Salina 50 times.
Nice.
And that's all it was.
It's going to end with us all doing the washing machine.
Well, it's going to end by one of the... Oh, shit. I got to finish that joke.
My mom's going to come and shoot Corey.
Hey, biggest fan, don't mind.
Oh, I would never do anything to hurt Selena. Why would you bring that up?
Yeah, why would you even say that?
Why would anybody... Wait. So...
Jennifer Lopez, no!
Jennifer Lopez.
So, well... We're really on track today.
Did you guys know that this whole island was a volcano?
You sure about that?
I was just thinking it.
You look like you don't believe it yourself.
I think you just pulled that out your ass.
It's called a hypothesis.
I think a scientific hypothesis has quite a bit of empirical research behind it.
I don't even have a cap, but I would tip it. I would tip it. Just wink at him.
Tip of the bear club.
Boy.
So you make it out to the field. Uh-huh. They didn't really give you a good idea of where these disappearances happened. They said they'd kind of just been happening around. They said look for the bear patches in the crop. So that's the best way to find them.
Bear patches?
Why would I use that word again?
Yeah,
I know what happens.
What the fuck, man?
I wonder if they're ripe this time of year. Go pick us some fresh bears. Berries, as they're called.
Get all down to the bear patch.
You keep using that word all you want.
So, yes, you are at the edge of the field, so...
I look around for a bear patch. So 15 plus nothing, so 15.
The bear attacks! No.
Oh, man, that would have been hilarious.
Bears everywhere. 15, you notice...
Patches of bears.
About 20 feet in, there looks to be a spot where there are... Crops are... They're in a formation, you know, in rows.
Okay.
Like you do crops.
I see that. I point over there and I say bears.
There's a spot where... There's a spot where there seems to be a... No crops at a circular fashion. I'm trying to not say bear.
Okay, well, I already pointed to it and said bears and started walking. So
there's a blank spot. I don't go towards the bears. If it's got babies, the mama gets pretty ornery.
Well, I continue walking. Anybody I ignore whatever Jedwin says.
I'm just going to follow him.
No, I want to go see. I want to inspect the crop circle. See if I can see any like man-made tools that made it.
Okay. Well, you gonna investigate?
Oh yeah, I'll investigate.
That's right. Investigation.
I look around as well.
Oh shit! I got 4 in investigation. I forgot I'm so smart. And I'm going to need it because I rolled another natural 1. Whee! So 5 altogether.
You suspect that this might have been caused by volcanic activity.
I'm going to investigate as well.
I got a 3.
I got probably a 3 also.
Can I take another look? Can I take another look? Because I'm just kind of...
Let's see Berea.
2. I got a 2.
Do you want to investigate?
Okay. I'll investigate. Perception.
I haven't heard Berea today.
Yeah, what's up with that?
Yeah, no, I don't know why he's been talking. What I will say is I'd look over at Fritz and say, don't worry, little buddy, this island can be volcano if you want it to be volcano. Whatever you believe. Okay.
It's a hypothesis.
7. Yeah.
All right, I'm going to do it one more time.
Everyone just go back to the village and tell him you couldn't find shit. Yeah.
We're going
to
take 10.
Take 10?
Yeah.
All right.
Take 10 bears.
Take 10 bears. All right. Well, that's what, an hour, I think, to take 10? Or is it 10 minutes?
It's 10 minutes.
10 minutes to take 10.
So just taking 10 minutes. 10 for 10. We're just sitting around in a crop circle?
We're giving it a once-over.
You're kind of...
Oh, okay.
I'll tell you a little about it anyway, because you still have eyeballs.
You didn't take those away from me.
Some of us don't have eyeballs.
LEDs. Hey, come on. Let's not be eyeless-ist.
Thank you, eyeless. Steven.
Robo-racist.
It's robophobic.
I am the robo-racist. Hashtag
kill all DMs.
You know what? I shut my eye holes and then sit down.
I am created to be the perfect racist. I hate all races.
Especially bicycle races.
Oddly enough, I love every other Queen song.
Doesn't hate bicycles,
today,
you idiot.
Today, guys, I'm doing a thing called stalling. All right.
It's where he tries to create a communist nation out of Russia.
I like...
It just looks like bare dirt. Fuck!
Oh shit, they're under our feet!
It just looks like plain dirt. The circle itself has a diameter of roughly 3 feet or so.
Okay.
And
I use the matrix system.
I mean, it's about 0.93 meters.
Thank you. Thanks for doing that for me.
You're welcome.
Nice. Thank you, Matt, doing that one for me.
Great.
How many neos are this?
You think that's dirt you're seeing now?
There are.
What if I told you?
It doesn't look like there's no trace of crops where they used to be. It looks like the crops are simply gone. Where they like there so are they obviously were harvested. Crops there. They weren't harvested. There's no spot where it looks like they were pulled out of the ground. It's just the dirt is very... It looks freshly tilled.
Who'd want to eat this shit anyways?
Like something dug through it.
Something dug through it.
It looks kind of soft soil.
Like sandworm.
Like something came up from underneath it?
Possibly.
Do I feel the ground like there are some gopher holes in it?
I feel the earth move.
Did you can feel a gopher hole underneath you?
Let me tell you about gopher holes.
If you'd like to make a roll for that, I guess that'd be what, knowledge nature?
Oh,
it'd be a roll for gopher.
Is knowledge nature even in
gopher?
Yeah, that's
a thing. Nature is definitely a thing, and I've got 7 to it, so I'm gonna
druids
got a 10. That's something. Oh my god. So I'm gonna take this dice and shove it.
Yeah. I'm gonna investigate it as well.
Are you just feeling around in the dirt?
Yeah.
What was that?
An 8.
They don't feel nothing like the swamps you're used to.
No, it's pretty dry. Usually the swamps, you put your hand too hard in there, you don't come back.
Just don't come back. So I put my head in some mud once.
One of the old men there killed himself by sticking his whole head in the ground. Pulled him out and the whole thing's gone.
Why would he put his head in the ground?
He wanted to die.
Oh.
Old Mr. Jesperton.
Jesperton. Come on. I'm gonna roll again. I'm going to investigate the crap out of this.
This episode will be called Take 10.
No joke.
Well, you already got 10.
Is that better? What is that?
That's 16, isn't it?
Here, use the strap as a catcher. That's what we're doing down here. It works pretty nice. That's...
Always use the strap as a catcher. Nice placement, Dusty.
You nailed it.
Let's do that little thing. There you go. Make a U shape.
Nah, don't do that.
Yeah.
Just ramp it.
It's like a diaphragm.
Just put it up. What?
I like my way better.
Back to Seinfeld.
All right. Okay, do it.
Okay, so I guess you're stomping around and...
Make sure you walk with that rhythm.
You find a spot that...
Oh, yeah, the sandworms.
Does seem... Like, I guess, kind of a little path around this hole that does seem like it's slightly softer.
Hmm.
I like it soft.
It's sandworms.
And... Gonna need a dex save from you.
No.
From Corey. Let's just roll randomly. What are you guys alphabetically?
I'm C.
Are you C?
Yeah.
No, 1, 2, 3, and then 4.
Carl, give me a dex save.
Got a 16.
The other one is under fumbles.
16, yo.
Oh, all right. He didn't stay in the village.
I got a 6.
I came with you.
I got a 6.
Okay. So, you feel the ground start to give underneath you, and you, with your knowledge of nature, you...
Your willingness to receive.
You leap out of the way, and two massive, I'm going to say probably about a foot and a half long, what look like pincers, come out of the ground and snap at where you were.
Giant antlion.
That's what I was just thinking. Yeah.
Same thing happens underneath Carl.
Eep.
He is not so lucky. They grab onto his leg.
Ouch.
Same thing with Fumbles.
Oh, Fumbles is with us?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he's just being quiet. I thought he was having diarrhea in the village,
the little dexterous one was not dexterous enough. Okay. So you share up. You hear from behind you because you didn't even know who he'd come with. You thought he was... still throwing up and vomiting and diarrheaing in the village. You just hear from me, I go, and so go ahead and roll initiative.
I missed the die roll thing.
Oh, we're all doing it. Right?
Yeah. Dude, my rolling sucks tonight, by the way.
Are we all rolling initiative or just him?
Everybody. You know shit's going down. Oh, wait, I only need to roll one initiative, don't I?
Hey, what did mine say?
11.
Ah, you changed it when you moved it, but sure.
Was it better?
I don't know.
I'll just re-roll if I hit.
I don't know what it was originally.
2.
Ah, damn it.
You should have taken the 11.
Whatever.
Mark, are you ready for me? Always.
Jedwin gets 20.
Shit. Okay.
I go last of 3.
10.
Carl 7 got a 9, so I go behind Barilla.
God, I can't remember any of your names.
Fritz.
Steven.
My name is Barilla Stromboli.
And what'd you get?
3.
Sorry, Carl.
7. Did I say... No, I wasn't 7.
Carl,
I was
7.
I was 9. Yeah, Carl 7 9. Got 9.
Fritz. That name's already too confusing.
Carl 7, 9.
Fritz Frittenfinkel.
1, 2, everybody's
the fine
rolling.
Bear.
The people. Fine bear. The forest walker.
People be rolling like
the anus stucker.
The Midnight Toker. Okay.
I almost wrote that once on an application. I put nights.
That you're a Midnight Toker?
No, that I was a Night Stalker. You're not a Night Stalker. And I looked at him like, should I leave it? Nah, I want this job.
Wait, you were actually going to put Night Stalker, not They'd Night like, Stalker?
Dude, that guy's famous.
No, I was going to like,
Byron.
Yeah. No. I just filled out a new application.
They probably just think you're actually a rapist that was joking about, I'm not really a rapist.
See? You won't think it's real if I make a joke about it.
Joke about it on application? Jesus. That'd be too crazy.
Hide in plain sight. I like it. Oldest
I should address this because I never seem to. When you have an NPC with you. Erdrin stayed in the town because he's...
Yeah, I was about to say, aren't we all by ourselves?
Did he get the stomach flu as well?
Yeah, he's investigating... basically, he's looking around trying to figure out how to get to the pork town, because it's been a while since
there's going
to
be
here.
A pork town? Shit. I love pork.
That town's pretty small. Where the hell is it going to go? There's one street and like two people.
Pork town.
Pork town.
I think Erdrin's just lazy.
So, yeah. All right. Jed goes first. So what you see before you is the one that snapped at Fritz has already pulled back into the ground. The one that grabbed...
Pulled Fritz into the ground?
There's one that's grabbed onto Carl. There's one that's grabbed on to...
Fumbles.
Fumbles back behind you guys.
What's this grabbed onto? My leg?
Yes.
Okay. I lift up my leg and I say, ground bear.
Ground bear.
I am going to shoot some... Eldritch Blast at the one holding Carl 7.
Okay.
Eldritch, I know that guy.
That's going to be a 13?
No.
And that's going to be a 10.
Yeah.
No.
Yep.
Playing games with my heart, man.
Okay, the one... holding Carl starts to pull, so make a strength check.
Beep.
What is with my shitty rolls today? 12. My rolls sucked in.
Is that all together?
Yes, that's all together.
You sink into the ground a little bit.
Oop.
Probably, I'm going to say up to your knees.
Would I have had advantage on one of these things because it was holding on to him and wouldn't be as mobile?
No, because you're shooting at a pair of pincers sticking out of the ground attached to somebody's leg.
Okay, well, could I have at least hit Carl so I feel like I did something?
Though I do think, let me see, there is something it says about grappling. Okay, it's just while they're grappling, they can only attack the creature they're grappling. But I'm choosing to have them pull you underground instead of bite you. So, you see Fumbles... and get pulled down to his waist. And I need... Oh, you jumped out of the way, so you're not in its path anymore.
Damn right I jumped out of the way. Because I've got nature on my side.
So, that's all you see for now. And it's Maria's turn.
Alright. So, So there's one that tried to get Fumbles pulled back in, and then one is attached to Carl's leg.
Mm.
Okay, I'm going to run up and try and swing my great axe at the one on his leg and say, "You get off my friend, you crazy ant farm!" And roll to hit. And that's going to be a 14. Does that hit?
Yes.
Right.
As Matt would do, 14, guys, 14. We got to hit it at 14.
Hey, you figured out my system.
Totally did. I see you writing it down over there like,
you did already roll 13.
I'm going to get really, really pissed and start raging. And hit him for 19 damage.
That's a lot. Good job.
Does it get him off my friend's leg?
Is that mine or Fumbles that you're hitting?
Oh, yours. Fumbles. Cool. Fumbles didn't connect.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
You do feel it loosen a little on you.
Yay.
All right. I'll try and attack it again to make it loosen all the way. And 10?
Nope.
Okay. Just kidding.
Hey, Matt.
Yeah.
10 did not hit?
10 didn't hit, but 14 did. Interesting.
You did not hit the tendon.
Oh,
look at you, jokes. Called you jokes. Because you got jokes.
Coral.
Coral swings his great sword down at the pincers. I said, bad ground bear.
Ground bear.
Motherfucker, I got a 9, and so I try to hit again. I got a 14. That's so it. I hit it.
Hey, when you slam the table, it flipped to a good number.
Yay.
Slam 19.
All right, so it's 2d6 plus 3, and I get to reroll my ones and twos. I haven't been doing that so far because I'm an idiot. But I'm going to reroll that one for 14 damage.
All right.
Take that. Oh, and I smite it. Okay. Because Steven was about to say.
I wasn't going
to. Oh, I mean, I don't smite it. I.
You could do it if you want.
I touch my pendant, and then I look at Jedwin, and then I stop touching my pendant.
Looks like you're touching your trach.
Hello, everyone.
Okay.
This is my real voice. I used to be a supermodel.
Wow.
I was a throat model.
So I...
Okay. All right, next joke.
It does unleash its grip on you.
Good.
I just thought about this. There are things called water bears, and they're little tiny, like, insects that live in water.
Tardigrades. Yeah, I've seen those.
Yeah, yeah. And I thought about it. I was like, ground bear, man, that makes me think of...
They're indestructible almost.
Yeah. Yeah. Isn't that crazy? Yeah.
In space,
baby. So I was just thinking about, like, these grabbing us if they had, like, little tentacles.
Yeep. No, thanks.
I still remember...
look up water bears, everybody.
This was a just because I love tangents. This water was a, bears. This was a Reddit post about a
water bear.
Well, on the subreddit for a local university that three of us,
Michigan,
have three of us have attended, and it was one basically asking people saying that people needed to be nicer, and that just because you say you use smarter words does not make them hurt less. And basically, somebody pulled it out of them. What happened was somebody called, like, I guess a person who was giving a presentation or something, a tardigrade.
What?
They were chunky.
That made them mad?
Look at it. What does a tardigrade look like?
Well, they're fat, but yeah. They're like roly-polies.
Yeah. It's a very specific way of calling someone fat.
It's like a Frasier way of saying someone's fat.
Yeah. I just thought that was really funny. Like, I don't know.
So that's this fancy word for roly-poly?
No.
A doodle bug?
They have just a bunch of folds.
Did you look at the picture Corey had?
Oh, that's what that was?
Yeah.
A water bear?
Yeah,
I thought it was a water bear.
Tardigrade.
Well, yeah, that's the proper name for it.
Water bear.
But I would be like, congratulations, you insulted me in like a clever way. Like, good job. I mean, it still hurts. Yeah, I get it. But...
That's when you punch him in the face.
Yeah.
And congratulate
Here's my clever way.
Now who's the top?
I never got that. I grew up as a fat kid, and people would always be like,
we all
fat kids.
I am a fat kid.
We're all still fat kids. People would always, you know, you get mad. People, what are you going to do, sit on me? And it's like, well, no. I
could.
I weigh a lot. So I'm going to punch you, and I have a lot of body mass, so it's going to hurt when I throw my entire body
into
a
punch.
Did
you punch anyone, Mark?
A few times.
Really? A few times?
Yeah.
I set on people before.
I know someone that...
Thanks for playing to stereotypes, Dusty.
Sorry.
I remember one person that you would have murdered.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a good story.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's not use names, because...
Right.
Yeah.
Also, Break. Make sure whenever you see fat people, you make them feel bad.
And call them a tardigrade.
Tardigrade. Don't call them a water bear. That could be way too misconstruing.
Fuck, it is... Okay, so that is still alive, but it unleashed its jaws from your leg. Cool. It is Fritz's turn.
Okay, so he's not, like, down in a hole. He's just... They, like, literally popped up and grabbed him.
Yeah, he's still down to his... skinnies.
To his knees.
In the dirt.
Okay, but no one's captured. No one needs something to hold on to.
I guess not.
Everyone's you can hold good. On to me if you want to.
That's fine. Okay, so is this thing still going back into the ground? Is it retreating?
It's still out of the ground. The jaws are out of the ground. They just let loose of his leg.
Okay, then I'm going to cast Entangle to keep him in place.
Nice.
So I'm going to...
You want to finally do what Steven gets to do every episode and explain the spell for us?
Yeah, it's grasping weeds and vines that spread out of the ground, which is the only thing that probably sprouts out of the ground here. Burn! Horticultural burn.
Sheetcrops.
In a 20-foot square, starting from the point within range for the duration, these plants are turning the ground into the area of difficult terrain. The creature in the area you cast spell must succeed a strength saving throw, blah, 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 or it's restrained by the entangling plants. So, yeah.
Plants.
So, yeah, it's got to make a strength checks against my stuffs.
Okay. What's the difficulty?
hard.
That'd be my spell. 15. What is my spell difficulty?
That's giving away DM secrets.
I actually have hard, easy, and medium.
Man, this is my first time to do spells. I'm so nervous.
Actually, or that'd be 20.
I'm pretty sure your DC check hard is going to be 8, plus your spell modifier, whichever one it is.
I had this written down.
And your proficiency bonus.
I was prepared. I knew I was. So proficiency bonus is 3, plus my stuff. Yeah, give me some book music, guys. Spell attack bonus is plus 6. That's pretty sweet.
Yeah, it's 8 plus whatever your spell modifier is. I think yours is wisdom.
Okay.
Your wisdom modifier plus your proficiency bonus, which it should be 3 for everybody.
So that's already plus 6, so 8 plus 6. Yeah. 14, yeah.
It shakes free of the vines.
What do you roll?
17.
Oh, fuck you.
Well, plus its bonus, so 20.
Double fuck you.
Trip.
Yeah, triple fuck.
And
shake out of my vines.
Okay, so it's still out of the ground. I'm going to use Thorn Whip.
Okay. So you pick up the vines that just got destroyed and use them.
It, magical whip, I don't remember how much damage it does, actually. Hold on.
Someone on the D&D subreddit had an illustration of that today.
Shout out to the D&D subreddit.
2d6 damage.
Hey, they put us on the podcast list.
Plus it gets pulled 10 feet towards me.
How did they put us on the official one?
The wiki.
The one, yeah, it's on the wiki.
Nice.
Okay.
We made it, guys.
Does it do a check?
Nope, I just have to hit it. It's a ranged attack.
Okay.
Nope. Motherfucker.
We are rolling shit tonight.
Yeah, we are.
What was it?
What
was it?
It was 10.
Okay.
Total.
So it's their turn now.
Hope they roll shitty.
Indiana bones it. Man, I suck with this whip.
I was cracking it and doing stuff. And
the one underneath Carl pulls back into the ground. Without Carl, obviously. So you see its jaws just disappear. The thing holding Fumbles pulls again, and you hear one last little, and Fumbles is underground.
I forgot about Fumbles.
I thought it didn't have him. I guess it reached up and grabbed him again.
No, it had him the whole time.
Yeah. I thought you said it didn't connect, and it wasn't holding him.
It was holding him. He went down to his
waist,
and then he went down the rest of the way.
Yeah. Oh, man, I was going to... I asked if anyone was still entangled.
We both asked.
Or if someone was still being pulled
down.
Rory,
play the tape.
Yeah, play the tape.
I kind of shrugged at you. Okay.
Whatever. Because I was going to try to entangle whoever was going down.
So when we looked to see who was captured, all we saw was shrugs of the DM.
Is anyone else captured? And why is there just a pasty dude standing over there?
Just shrugging at us.
I don't know. That's what you see most of the time.
Yeah, pretty much.
Even I'll wake up in the middle of the night and just a dude in the corner is just shrugging away.
Power shrugs.
Why are you here? Is it Portlandia shrug?
I haven't seen too much of that one.
Well, Portlandia, they have a bunch of actors that they can't pay to actually speak, but they still have them around, and so they have a bunch of fun with it, where it's like they go up and ask one of the extras, is like, so what do you think about this? And all they can do is just smile and shrug because they can't say anything. That's great.
SAG.
Love it.
SAG?
I assume it's because of SAG rules.
Screen Actors Guild?
Yeah.
Okay. If you don't have a SAG card, you can't have a speaking role in a movie.
I see. Interesting.
So, big gulps, huh?
Oh, yeah. The Bill Murray thing.
Everyone make a dex save.
Dex save?
Oh, yeah. Actually, shouldn't it be strength save? Well, dex save to see if they catch you.
15, motherfucker.
It's confusing.
What did mine say? Mine's red.
I guess I gotta compare these up.
Nat 20.
You got 2.
For real? A 2? God damn it.
I got a 3. 6. Mine's 6 total.
My, how the turntables.
I need some goddamn rolls.
6 total.
And what did Carl get?
15 is what
15.
Is.
Okay.
What the fuck is so this tonight?
Buddy leaps into the air. and
goes all fucking Harrison Bergeron and leaps to the ceiling.
I attach to the clouds.
To the clouds. Carl just kind of, in a sort of non-committal way, just kind of steps to the side and manages to dodge. And our resident magic users are both grabbed by some jaws.
Hey, I'm a magic user.
Oh, damn, I've been snatched.
You are. We found that out.
Yeah, I have spells
you
and
got
shit.
Your spells.
Let go of me, you bastards.
Okay.
So, yeah, now it's Buddy's turn.
All right.
Help me, pasta man. Help.
Kind of went George Bush on that one. I like it.
Yeah, yeah. Any southern-sounding person, I'll probably switch to them at some point.
I love it.
Is our Barillas learning? All right, I will...
Help me, Mr. Pasta man. I love it.
Fooled, I can't get fooled again.
All right, I'm going to roll to help out Jedwin.
Oh,
so what's it?
Am I chopped liver? What is this?
He gave me the bush voice, man. So it's attached to your leg, I guess?
You touch his leg because he gave you the bush. Now no roll.
All right.
What all a right. treat.
So, 21.
Yes.
All right. And 20. Jesus.
What's the damage?
That is damage.
Yeah, 20 damage. And I will slice at it again. This thing's not dead yet. And I'm so bad at math. Yes. 25.
Yes, you hit.
All right. 12 Collins is a very good 10. D&D.
No, 12, sorry.
Too much sugar.
How much? 12?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Coral.
Coral!
Coral goes after his little friend, Fritz. I hit him. No, I'm just
not. dang. Error.
I swipe at him. I do a 15.
Shit. Yeah.
Well, I do more than that. It's like 17. Okay. And I forgot to roll damage. I'm sorry. My bad.
Initiate friend kill mode.
4, 6, 10 plus 3 is 13.
Okay.
And then I do it again.
Okay.
I don't have to smite these guys, do I?
You can do whatever
you want.
Yeah, dude, this is
Steven,
your character.
What do I do?
This is your character.
Steven, tell me what to do now.
Follow your dreams, Matt.
Okay, and this is a 16, which is a hit.
That's a hit.
And which is 10, 13. So I do 13 more damage
okay.
to it. I go ahead and smite it, just for good measure.
Okay.
I smite it. I do a level 1 smite, which is 2d6.
2d8.
2d8.
Damn.
Yeah. 8 damage. Not bad. Okay. Cool. That uses up a slot.
Boop. All right. Spin. Fritz.
Well.
You can, when you're grappled, you can attack it. You can do your spells, everything the same. Or you can try to break free using a strength check.
I want to break free.
I don't even know what song that was.
I want to break free.
Yeah, how did you not know that song? Yeah,
I don't
know that song.
We literally made a joke about it early in the podcast.
Yeah, man, you laughed at it.
Carl Seven
you
loves
laughed,
every other
Steven.
Song.
You laughed.
I don't remember, man. My memory lasted about 3 seconds.
Let's
like
see.
Like a drunk
here.
Goldfish.
Well, only my short term, though. Like, I remember who all of you are, but I forget why I'm here about every minute or so.
Shit, where am I? Oh, yeah, that's right.
Grandpa Steven's here playing D&D.
I was just about to say that. Like, I had to drive my grandpa from a very sad hospital to, like, my brother-in-law's house, and, yeah, his mind's basically gone. I have to, like, remind him who I am, like, every minute or so.
Thank you for tuning into Depressing Roll.
No, but it was like an hour-long drive, and so I can just imagine he's sitting there in a car, and he's constantly just sort of like looking around. It's like, who is this person driving me? Where
are we
the
there
fuck
yet?
Am I
are
going?
Are we there yet?
Just go with it. Like, don't make him mad.
Like, just... Memento, only like more sad.
Oh.
So you know need to tattoo things right on now? Your grandpa's arm so he'll remember.
All right, I'm going to spray some fucking acid at this thing because I'm upset. And so, let's see here. So, I extend my hand toward the creature. You get it. I shoot acid out of my palm.
Yeah.
All right.
What
so,
is it?
It must succeed a constitution save.
Okay.
Or it takes 2d12 worth of damage.
It rolled a 1.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and just roll my two d12s and see what the fuck happens. That's a 12.
Ooh. Max damage.
And that was a 1. So 13.
Unmax damage.
Complete opposite. So 13, yo.
Let me do some head math. All right. You flick down some acid at it, and...
I don't flick it.
What do you do?
Flick it real
I like
good.
Spider-Man wrist it.
That's what I was thinking, though. Flick.
Yeah, I don't know. Flicking just sounds like I've flicked it like with my fingers all flicked.
All daintily.
Like, get out of here.
Skeets it.
Get on at it.
Get out.
Get out of here. Get on. Yeah. All right. You...
Yeah.
Some acid at it. Yeah, and finger things. You see it run down, and you hear a very loud sizzling as the acid eats in.
How does it smell? Smell good?
It smells like chitin being melted by chemicals.
I think that probably smells good. To me, that is. To me. I'm my own person.
Yeah. Everybody else is kind of coughing a little bit.
Just all the horrible smokes and
the horrible
gases
fumes.
Coming off of that.
I'm just used to it from being in the lab. It's no big deal.
The creature, you hear it almost a, not a squeal, because they don't really make noise, but it shakes violently and pulls back into the ground, and as it does, the jaw sort of things.
Pincers.
Yeah, the mandibles.
Mandibles.
Ooh, good one.
Mandibles.
Are break off and are laying on the ground in front
Fair
of you.
Jaw.
Do they look intact?
Pick them up and put them.
For the most part, they're kind of melted at the bottom.
Can you make the bangs out of those?
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
I'm going to...
Pincer bangs.
I'll wait till we're done. I'll wait till we're done, but I'm eyeballing them. And I'm like, dibs. Dibs.
It's Jed's turn.
Well, I'm not going to pass a strength check, that's for sure.
Yeah, man, don't do it. You never know.
Splash some acid. It worked for me.
I'm going to do a shocking grasp.
Take some acid, bro. Shocking grasp.
Drop some acid.
Shocking grasp.
Shocking grasp?
Shocking grasp.
Like, will we be impressed by this?
You will be shocked.
Setting it up for a hoop shot.
It does 2d8 lightning damage, and they get no reaction for the rest of their turn.
Okay.
Hmm. Yeah, take that reaction.
So they just take it, and they're like, I don't know how to respond
That's
to this.
That's a 24 with 1 and 8, so 9 damage.
Okay.
It's electricity, too, so it probably didn't feel too good.
So you reach down and grab one of the mandibles around your leg, and just the rest of you just hear crackling and smell more burning chitin. But this time it's chitin that's been burnt with heat instead of chemicals.
Ooh, we're fun.
Yeah.
So with all the chemicals and like machinery smells, does it smell like burnt chitin? That's a Red Dwarf joke.
Nice.
Is a guy's name Bert?
His name is Bert Crichton.
That was good. That was really good.
Sorry.
A little obscure, but yeah. Hopefully you guys get that.
Only 90s British kids will get this.
A tip of the cap to all of our British 90 kids. All
right. But yeah, you smell burning, and that's the one that Birdie already attacked. So yeah.
You were throwing up support.
The slack kind of loosens on your legs, and it doesn't seem to be moving anymore. There's just smoke coming off of it.
Smells like dinner. Swamp chicken is what we used to call these things.
You still in combat?
I'm going to call that an end to combat.
I investigate to see if I can see where fumbles anymore. Went.
I go pick up those two mandibles laying on the ground by
the
door.
No, don't
do it. No.
Reaching over with my feetsies. Okay.
I scatter over to where fumbles went to the ground, and I sort of like reach my hand into the ground. I try to.
Okay.
I rolled a natural 1, so I like
just
hurt my wrist as I
punched the ground.
Punched the ground, yeah.
Pain.
No, you guys just see me run over, punch the ground, and then just get up and like look at all of you guys without saying anything.
Okay, what's everybody else doing?
I just walk over to where Carl 7 is and I go, shit.
I'm just gonna pace around and look in the dirt and see if any of those little swamp creatures are coming out again.
I'm going to have to grab a mandible and inspect it.
Of course.
So I'm inspecting the the mandible.
All right, it's like I said, it's about a foot and a half long.
Oh, I got to write down that I have a mandible now.
Did you get one? It is
it is kind of orangish brown in color and barbed at the end.
Barbed,
just like my pingus.
Horrible.
There's also a fully intact one sticking out of the ground.
No, we'll take the ruined one.
That you fried.
Yeah, that I fried.
Yeah, I'll pick it up. Why not?
Yeah, well, can no, I...
It's,
can
the,
I
just, it's still attached to
can
the
I break off some of that and eat
oh,
it?
Oh, the creature's dead?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sticking out of the ground?
Yeah.
Oh, Eureka.
Urethra.
I'm going to go look at that one. Okay. I'm going to go...
Just
I'm
gonna, throws the mandible.
Yeah, the other one just throw it behind me.
Wait a minute. What's that? All right. It's, like I said, it's just the jaws sticking out of the ground and a tiny bit of head. And you can tell it looks...
all you need.
It's true. Just the tip.
Just... you can see the head appears to be, you know, insectile in nature.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Little... Six little feet all crawling around.
Oh, you're teasing. You're teasing.
Oh, man. Tickle tease.
I'm on the edge. Oh, yeah.
Little ants crawling all over.
So it's an insect.
Sometimes they bite. Sometimes they don't.
I'm going to use my strength to try to pull it out of the ground.
Okay. I'm going to use my strength to rip my ears off.
All right. Carl Seven grabs the mandibles and... pulls up without, you know, in a very mechanical fashion. I'm just imagining, like, he grabs down and you don't, yeah, like, you don't actually see his back flex at all. Just pulls him up and it pops out of the ground.
Nice.
Leaving a pretty nice sized hole. Let me go ahead and, this is not going to help the viewers at home, but I'm going to show everybody a picture and then we're going to kind of talk about it.
I love pictures.
Oh, man, I wish you guys could see this picture.
Wish there was a website we could post this to that everyone could see it later on.
Perp.com. You're right. It looks like a giant anteater.
Nice. Kind of. It looks like the Pope
slash
with
mantis
like crazy
thing.
Ant arms.
That's super duper hot.
It looks
guys.
Like a hydralisk.
Yeah. From yeah. If you guys have ever played StarCraft, it does look like a hydralisk.
Has anyone else ever heard of StarCraft? A little game that came out not too long
it's
ago.
Not, I mean, it's not really well known. Unless you're Korean, then it is your religion.
Oh,
I feel like
that's racist.
I feel like Dota and all those MOBAs have taken over.
They kind of
StarCraft
have
popularity.
That's sad.
You guys have lost me at MOBAs. Is that what you just said?
League of Legends.
Multiplayer
shit.
Online battle arena. Come on, dude! It is the pinnacle of modern gaming.
Okay, I gotta say, I went in.
I thought that was kind of funny, but I'm cracking up because of how much Rory found it funny.
Yeah.
That made me laugh. Wow.
Come on.
That fucking voice.
That's my Snagglepuss interpretation.
Heavens to Megatroid.
Heavens to Murgatroyd.
And then it gets a little bit of the
oh my goodness.
The Oni NG voice, the... Ron Weasley.
Oh, yeah.
Weasley.
Stop. Okay.
Learn to play, guys.
Well, I have to say my Dota story. I went into the Steam Big Picture for some reason. It showed Dota 2 is one of my most recently games played, and I've never installed it or played that at all, so I don't know why it's trying to say I did.
It's too spoopy, but you should play Dota 2. Pinnacle of gaming.
I think Steven's been on my computer. He alternates between under my couch and Matt's couch.
So it's about
a tunnel.
A series of underground tunnels connecting to Corey's apartment.
A sticky, like,
flooded.
Okay, what's...
It's about 4 feet long.
Nah, not near that much. About
and
3.5 inches.
And it looks like
a good day.
It looks like the thing I described. And
it actually does.
And when you pull it out, it left a nice big hole.
What are you trying to imply,
Mark? Don't even touch it.
I just
don't touch it.
I just signaled Steven.
No one does.
Shit, that setup was perfect.
Man, layup tonight. Just laying them up. Oh my god. Okay, so there's a giant gaping hole. where this thing was.
Yes.
Do we all jump into it?
Let's do it, guys.
How deep is the hole?
Jump into the sand.
I don't know. Roll. You want to look down it?
Yeah, I want to look in the hole.
Okay. Roll for it.
I'm going to roll for...
roll for hole.
I don't know if I have dark vision.
Four.
You can tell it's a hole.
You
see a lot of dirt.
Hey, Jedwin, what is that?
Seven, not four.
Okay.
I want to inspect.
Is it still a hole?
It's still a hole.
This is a big old hole down here, guys.
There's still a volcano. Now, see, what you got here is a pretty typical hole. They got these all around these parts. Yeah. What'd you get?
I didn't roll yet. I was wanting to inspect the blood of the insects, creatures.
Okay.
Oh, you gonna, seem a little hesitant, like you don't want to do it in front of people.
No, I'm gonna inspect it.
I'll put your pants back on.
I've got like a vial ready just in case. It's interesting.
Okay, where are you taking this blood from?
The urethra, of course.
That's vile, dude.
It's already got a wound. It's pincers got.
Okay, so from one? The one you pulled up?
No, the one that was. Oh yeah, the other one.
I mean,
was
it got
kind of
hacked up by Maria.
Yeah, the other
was
one,
electrocuted.
The other one was electrocuted. I forgot about that. I don't know. Has he got blood coming out of his mouth or something?
Well, now you're... I'm trying to think, because insects don't really have blood. They've got some, like,
I just want to know if there's some...
They've got green stuff.
Is there goo coming out of it?
They've got green blood. It's made of
vegetables. I didn't mean to say blood, DM.
Well, I just wanted to know where you're taking it from. This is important.
It's important?
Yeah.
Pop quiz
wherever
story.
The most important for me to look is, Mr.
on,
DM,
nature
sir.
Boy.
I don't know.
Does he need to roll a nature check or something?
Yeah, I'm poking and prodding at it.
Let's roll a nature check. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. I'll do that all day.
Because he might know what this is. You're a druid.
What is that?
It is an end cake.
Pancake?
I don't know what an end cake is. What?
Put
is
some
it?
Syrup in the vial, Corey.
That's what that thing is called. He's telling you knew what it was.
All right, so it's
at least biology shit.
18. I rolled an 18.
Okay, yeah, they are. It's an end keg. They are sometimes colloquially known as tunnel lice. They are
tunnel lice rule.
Yeah. Nice.
They are.
that was great.
On fire tonight, Steven.
Yeah, seriously.
On fire.
I've got nothing. Steven's carrying it.
But, okay.
They are
tunnelized. Gotcha.
Territorial creatures. obviously, from their secondary name, they are tunnelers. They don't really make permanent tunnels. They kind of tend to close things off behind them.
Ah, that's good to know.
Yeah.
For everyone who's about to jump in the hole.
So they shit out dirt behind them.
Well, no, just the way they dig, because they have giant pincers that
they scoop
dig
it
with
down behind them.
Back legs are douches, and they just kick the holes, and
so they just kind of leave soft dirt in their wake. Yeah, they tend to keep fairly large colonies. So yeah,
I'm just gonna relay that to everybody. I'm sure they care. I'm giving them more of a lecture.
Everybody,
I sure wish I knew what this thing was. It deeply disturbs me that I do not.
I still have the thing in my hands, right?
Mm-hmm.
I start circling around, holding it out, and then I throw it as far as possible.
So you do like a so long a Bowser spin and toss it?
Yeah, exactly.
So long a Bowser.
Is that what he says?
I thought it was just gibberish.
No, he says, so long, Bowser. When we were kids, people used to think he was saying, so long, gay Bowser.
Yeah. I rolled a 21.
Totally. All right. It flies off into the distance.
Cool.
Little star.
Yeah.
Ding.
Towards town?
Yes.
Okay, lands in their
in
fountain.
In classic Matt fashion.
In the fountain.
The guy's sitting in the fountain just staring at his reflection. He's soaked.
Now it's infected and all of our drinking water.
You just hear... you hear just kind of whispering from the ethereal plane a dwarven voice. Good.
Hey, it's like Slagathor's with me.
Just a whisper on the wind. Good.
See previous episodes of no.
No.
Okay,
that was before the mic.
Before the Mic.
We kick I love Mike that off name. Of our group.
We need to make a like a Before the Mic mini series where we go and tell these stories. Anyway,
I like that name, Before the Mic.
Yeah,
did y'all awesome. Steal that from something?
I don't know. Did no. you?
Oh, cool.
I love it.
Were we original?
Copyrighted.
Copyrighted. Nobody can take
ours.
That.
It's ours now.
Trademark.
Trademark.
2016 Party Bro Podcast.
Registered. The little R symbol.
Before the Mic.
Yeah. What's
your title? Yeah, no, we're good. That's an episode.
All right, so.
Do you want to end it there?
You've got a hole.
Okay. And we got bugs. That there's
got a hole and a whole lot of nothing.
Big. There's a big.
Oh, did anybody else want to inspect the hole?
Yeah,
I did a bad job.
Yeah, everyone inspect the hole right now.
Roll to hole.
Roll to hole.
Can I try again? Because I got another joke.
What do I?
just make the joke.
I look in the hole and go, "Holy shit!"
That wasn't
okay. Worth rolling again. 15 for hole.
15 also.
All right, what's bring it again?
Is this inspection or yeah. perception?
Inspect. Whichever.
18.
Okay. You guys all hold hands and look down in the hole together. And you all simultaneously, except for Jedwin, who's standing in the back cracking jokes.
Love it.
So you all look together and you notice that there is a very visible path down there. It does not look like it was closed off.
You guys are pathfinders.
I was thinking it, dude. I was
thinking. And at that, I'm going to go ahead and close this episode of the Party Roll.
Good job. All
right. All right, catch us next time.
Thank you. Good night.
See you later.
Follow our Twitter roll and our Facebook roll.
All the rolls.
All the rolls.
PartyRollPodcast.com roll.
Clown roll.
Okay, bye.